Sighing is an involuntary action that starts out like a normal breath, but before you breathe out, you take an extra inhale, creating the extra deep breath we're all familiar with. If I was to ask you, how often do we sigh? What would your answer be? Once an hour? 10 times a day? Most people, including myself, are pretty surprised when they learn that we actually sigh roughly every 5 minutes. Sighing might not seem that important, but without it, we wouldn't be around for very long. To understand why sighing is so helpful, we first need to understand the structure of the body's breathing machines, the lungs. The structure of our lungs is similar to an upside down tree, with a large trunk and many branches coming off. The tree trunk of our lungs is known as the trachea, which is the hard structure you can feel on the front of your neck. The trachea splits off to give two main branches that supply each lung, known as the right and left bronchus. The basic purpose of breathing is gas exchange, where oxygen enters our lungs during an inhale and carbon dioxide leaves during an exhale. When we inhale, the air flows down the trachea, into each bronchus, and down a series of progressively smaller tunnels until it reaches tiny little air sacs known as alveoli. The alveoli are the finish line for the air and they are perfect for gas exchange. Alveoli have really thin walls, which gives them a really big surface area. This makes it easy for the oxygen to move out and the carbon dioxide to move in. They are also closely surrounded by blood vessels, so the gases don't have very far to travel. The alveoli may be tiny, only 300 microns in diameter, which is about half the size of a pencil lead, but what they lack in size, they make up for in number. Each lung contains roughly 300 million alveoli, which means we have about 600 million places for oxygen to get into our body and carbon dioxide to get out. The alveoli act like a balloon, inflating as we breathe in and deflating as we breathe out. Sometimes when our alveoli deflate, they collapse because as the air rushes out, the surface tension inside their walls is too great for them to maintain their shape. Losing too many alveoli can become a problem because eventually we won't have enough alveoli available for good gas exchange. Luckily, we have a solution for this: sighing. A normal breath alone is not powerful enough to overcome the surface tension in the collapsed alveoli. However, when we sigh, we take a second inhale, sending a much larger volume of air into our lungs, which is enough to beat the surface tension and pop open the collapsed alveoli. The importance of sighing is not only interesting, but has actually been life-saving. There are people suffering from conditions that weaken their respiratory muscles, sometimes meaning they can't breathe on their own. These people often have to rely on mechanical ventilation, where a machine changes the pressure inside their lungs so they can inhale and exhale. During the early days of mechanical ventilation, there were still a lot of people who passed away despite the machines helping them breathe. The reason? The machines weren't creating sighs. Once the machines were programmed to give an extra large breath every now and then, the number of people dying drastically decreased. If you see anyone on mechanical ventilation today, you'll notice that roughly every 5 minutes, the ventilator will give them an extra large breath. This is the artificial sigh, popping open the collapsed alveoli to keep their lungs working as well as possible. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and consider subscribing for a new video every Saturday about the science of everyday life.